Yeah, that we are supposed to know is how the elements are communicated with respect. Of how communication happens between the elements, like how the service port will be related to the binding and then to port type operation, how are we going to contain the input and output operation, and in this like fault operation wherein we want to send some error messages. Operation can contain different types of messages, and messages can contain different data types. Going to write the Java class, you should get a picture in your mind related to the WSTL first. WSTL, or if you are going to top down approach, you created your service. Let us say this method, this addition method, shows some sending the data in terms of. Purpose I have created one more web service. With add which strings instead of integers. Data, I'm just calling it to an integer, and that I'm adding numbers and finding the data also as a string. I'm just giving the flexibility to the user or to accessing only the integer. Here floating points, doubles, and it can accept and normal string values. As a client, when he is expecting only the addition of two numbers or point numbers, he was not supposed to send the data to a character. You can perform the addition operation only between numeric data types. You can perform the concatenation operation between two strings, but we are not bothered about that right now. Integer dot parseInt, and if you pass a string, then it's definitely going to fail with number format exception. So you can specify, you can pose some kind of exception, or you can handle that exception and you respond back to the client. But between client and server will be going to happen only based on SOAP protocol. So first, the request also, it will be going to wrap up your SOAP. That's what any phase. Then which contains an error information, like user has some string, some presentation of parsing method has thrown in a format exception. So your SOAP will be going to constructed with a fault message, the fault, the body, full response information, but this your is fault information, and the was supposed to handle that particular error, and he needs to get or retrieve the error message and the error code. So instead of you sending the response inside the body, you'll just respond a fault. The fault contains a fault or faulting or detail. Code is nothing but your error code and your client have decided. Error code, client can understand like this is a client error or this error or issue with respect to the header. So on the fault code, the client can easily understand the issue and he can fix it and he's going to trigger the request one more time. And contain some extra information, like get the normal message instead of error code. If you can take a look at the error message also, he'll be able to understand in more detail. To see how to read a fault message with respect and how to handle the fault response or response with the client. And we'll take at one real world example. We'll jump UDDI registries, SIGDA. Here we'll take a look at some temperature conversions which will be going to convert from Celsius to Fahrenheit. For this one first, and we'll start with the fault data. Just went to this website yesterday, I have suggested, right? Website SIGDA.com. History, and currently we want a small example for temperature so in the text box I searched for temperature. It started with all the available services with respect to our temperature. And this one, temperature conversion available. Remember, UDSTL contains the endpoint information as well as how the request response communication should happen and the transport protocol. So let's take the WSTL file. Clear, just let me know. I'm using normal audio conference. Some location. STL file. Okay. Now create a small project for use of the WSTL and create a client by Apache CX. So to some location, just drag and drop. WSTL file. What is that? Matching XML is not allowed. We can place it anywhere. We have the option, the CXF has the operating the client at any place. So yeah, so there is no, just a WSTL file. What we are doing, we are not at all using our local ID automatically. Tried, we have created a additions or arithmetic service that provided a service. We have written, after that we have written one client as well. In that sense, the service onto our local host only, accessing from the same location and go to the UDDI. Because you didn't register your service at the UDDI layer. We don't want any of other clients to come and take a look at our arithmetic operations service. We want the client and use the existing services again. Service was already available at the UDDI layer, and you had the UDDI layer and you just download the WSTL file. So is enough to the endpoint address CXF capability of generating and today we have seen the topic or from Java to WSTL conversion. I used a tool called Java to WSTL today in depth one by one. WSTL tool is used to generate a WSTL as well. WSTL to Java also available with respect to your Apache CXF. So if you add the WSTL file, your CXF will be going to generate classes and the classes, the thing, but your service or your application class. So it will be going to generate a client or server code if you need. Your Apache CXF folder first. What are all the folder or file Apache CXF? Your lib contains all the required jar files, and you get JAXPI. JAXPL the XMS, which is used for converting your STL file into G code, you need XML beans. And lot of bad file, nothing but that WSTL to Java. Java, which will be going to convert WSTL, the web service description language, into Java objects and to WS. So are used by Apache CXF, and if it during the object generation and we'll be going to generate all the required class files. Correct external WS file on the WSDL file. And go to want only client test with Web Service Explorer, which means first time we have verified one Web Service Explorer window, so that is the same. And generate Java Bean skeleton, so and after that generate client. So currently only in generate client. Of selecting the project, whether you want to select at the same location or you want to place at different location. So currently at our client. And same, and this is a runtime, it is Apache CXF 2.x. The WSDL file already, if it you need to find out, because any we right click on the file, so it will be going to populate automatically. Click on type name, give it as is, click on next, and it will be going to show you all these preferences. See these options, how it has retrieved these people with respect to preferences, Apache CXF configuration. If you go to that Sandeep. See that it has used the command Java 2WS and all required path that it was supposed to use to generate the required class. Jax WS to Jax B. So this means all your data types will be going to converted into SS and generate the so go your project now. So he has created the package and has loaded all the class files. While in the double, what it has done is it hasn't created a separate package for your JAXP. If you just place create a separate package and place all the JAXP. Just go and verify what that are available with respect to your WSDL. Open structure. Of response foreign CS and the wind request and wind foreign heat soap request and response consists of four operations and each operation consists of a request and response input message. Soap address bind it to temperature. So each operation, go back to, consists of a input message and output message. So these input and output messages. One, each operation consists of output your data types. So it was referring like one here, it consists of the display for cells and also consists of a decimal value like whenever it has called, whenever it from Celsius to foreign heat, it will be going to respond with a decimal value. So for each complex element, it will be going to generate a separate .xp file. Files that got generated. Only one element of value. So for all the so it will be going to generate a dummy client. Even though it was not required, your Apache CXF will be going to generate the one class and will take a look at nothing but for JAX-WS. So JAX-WS would contain all the annotations for web service. The package called JavaX.xws package. The package contains all the required annotations. So like web service defines so that the interface is as a web service. We're going to specify it at both the service point level and the service implementation level. But this implementation level, we are supposed to specify a parameter called endpoint interface. Actual is endpoint interface. Classes dot code created. Soap type. Function soap type. Let us quantify in your WSTL file. How many spaces? your port type, it will contain from the port type, which will contain about your options. So your operations will be specified in your port type. So that will be specified as your web service, which will be going to contain the options of type, and will be going to contain a target namespace. So the target retrieved from your dist file, if you go and look at the top, it will contain that one. See, only based on the WSDL file. Going to contain all thirds or corresponding operations in your WSDL file, all the annotations. Like first one is that web is nothing but your operation from the port type. Go down. Operation. Or let me call this one. You will be your name and that properly. Sorry. Operation, your name will be your chapter name. You can see that your method web consists of a parameter called operation name, which is going to point to the same name. And it is nothing but the response that you want to return back to the client. So type is failures to foreign heat result. If you want to verify the message, it will be going to contain the same. Namespace, again it will be going to point to the same because we don't have different states and we are referring to only one WSDL or one XST file. And the actual elements, the elements for your request object, response wrapper, which will need to specify actual message for your response object. An additional attribute class name, which will point to your actual request object in terms of that speed. If you didn't, there won't be any issue with that. Each and every method is going to contain certain parameters. So, will be going to specify, will be used to specify the parameter for your object. Celsius, in our file we have four operations, so there are four methods corresponding to each and every operation available in the prototype class. Main interface that is used by the client. The port type port, this particular port type port. Discuss about the binding part. The server part. Temperature. The temperature conversions will be able to extend one interrupt, which is javax.xml.ws.service, which is that service client. So called web service client, which will be going to inform to your JAX.ws that this is a web service client, and then it's nothing but your service and your actual location of the service and the that See, not socket communication between two systems will be the socket communication, but your JAX-WS or your going to handle all the level calls, but it's your ability to generate a URL object fast, URL object to the connection or web, which will be or establish the connection to the server. See here, you can see that this is a static block, which only once this block whether you are going to process the client, this object will be going to created only once, because we, the URL object, because we going to it's necessary for long time into the memory. There are get temperature conversion soap with no parameters, and here you can see that web service feature dot 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 features. So what can anyone use this? Verilogs we have discussed in our arguments. Yeah, from 3-4 people. Core Java features, because you're going to get at any point of time, if you move to any of the advanced concepts, you'll definitely going to get all the core Java concepts. Here they are using one particular method, which is get temperature conversion soap. So this temperature conversion soap, what we have mentioned, this is a service. Go to your service now. So what is the name of the port? Your IP is temperature conversion soap. So for this particular one, they have added a getter method. So object, you can get a getter method to retrieve the port. You have to do all the methods by using the port. Just now seen all the methods how to access by using port type. Conversions, which is your web service client, which what, and after that you'll be going to call the service and soap, which only call super port. It will be going to call get port method. So going to establish the connection to your server at the specified. Temperature conversion soap type IMPL. This is just an implementation for your soap type, which comes of a dummy implementation for all your methods. So no bother about this, because we are not going to call these methods. This is the temperature conversion soap type underscore temperature conversion soap underscore client. Time your queue name specifies the namespace or X space, and your WSTL is or your JAX WS is very strict about queue name. If you specify or properly, it won't call the service. In client, you can see that I'm using the main method. You can see that I'm creating an order temperature conversions. I'm creating a service. Once after that, I'm calling the get conversion soap, which means it will be able to retrieve a port me. See, just our understanding, they have used the object name. Port. Go to your temperature dot get temperature conversion soap, which will retrieve a port object. So create one object and will be retrieve a port, but normally it will be contact the server and connection at that time and will be handle. You can like it will be going to handle an object for you. Once you got the port object from the you have access to all the methods like Celsius to foreign heat or wind chill in Celsius or the Bosa kind of stuff, any kind of methods. Just able to access the methods for an object in the same here also, you will be able to access those methods. Where is my client? The port. So if you say port dot, you will see all the methods that are available with respect to your port. So of all the operations, go to your yeah. See, then from the we are going to the port, which is we are going to all these methods. Method, execute the method with to so currently this one is converting from cells and heat. So just press 0 as of now. I don't want to work mining methods. Just work on converting and I'm passing 0. And all are available. If you, you can just change the names for your opinions or to call to foreign heat and will be to pass the value in big decimal format and will be going to respond back with some value and I'm just printing that value. About WSTL location, which is not URL. So our not at all talking to our local server, we are talking to some location which is web.tfhosting.com. This particular talking now. So I can easily send a request over the internet to the service provider. I can contact the service and can get the response. normal. My system is very slow. And you can see that it has sent the request to that, and it was able to receive the response as 32. It is 32, that is correct. Enter some number 20, probably for kind of stuff. So this provider is up and running, and we are able to communicate to the service provider over the web, and we are able to retrieve the result. Now, at least elements that are, and because of all those elements, and how those elements are related to WSDL file. Sort of. Once over the class, Sandeep. No, your purpose. The fault related stuff. For this, web service using dynamic web project. So that means I can just copy the related files like webinf and metainf to Tomcat location, and I can deprecation. I'm sorry.
Okay, question was, you know, are we going to do something different with with respect to web service when compared to a regular web application in deployment?
No, we deploy it as a normal application, normal web application to the top. If you deploy it in using distracted with some other question. Deploy using enterprise server, so you have the option of writing the AND script, and your script consists of the tools like WSDL to Java, whatever that we have discussed with respect to Apache CXF. But such like what WSDL to Java that you want to perform, and give the WSDL file, and provide source files, application for dependent class files. So provided with the AND command, and it will be going to generate the required your Java the JAXP classes, and you're going to wrap it up using a var file, and we'll be going to deploy it to the server.
Okay,
cool. Welcome. Command we'll be going to discuss during this weekend or next week, but we'll see. Another question here, are we using marshalling and unmarshalling like we used in JAXP? It's not for us to do, the process will be taken care of our JAXW. Yes. The classes available and the marshalling or unmarshalling, everything will be going to do internally over JAXWS, and it will be going to wrap up the SOAP later and then communicates with the server. Access CA2.x. Explain the marshalling and unmarshalling is just for our understanding purpose how the object is converted to an XML. Did we? service endpoint interface. Escalation, so select one method, click on giant only, no server. Done is instead of placing it as an integer, we convert that into string values. Now we accepted by using strings, so if we pass the strings now, it got deployed onto the Tomcat. Go and verify the WSTL that got generated. So this was generated by our Apache, and the endpoint location. Go on. Enter a error whether it was opening the WSTL or not. It was, the application was deployed properly onto the server. Instead of now it consists of string values. It was there in a separate project. Some classes related to Jack and our classes. Go to verify correctly or not. Values. So current entering 10. First, whether we are able to see the positive or not. In add dot result equal to 45. So our service is working fine. Stopping the Tomcat server here because we'll be going to my client. I will watch it. String operations, fine. Go to our client and server, both are available at the same location, so make use of the same that will get overridden. here and we can see the server processing in our and execute it now. Yesterday we have seen this. Finally, it will be going to respond with return. Now change this to string. Exception at the server level itself, because our ops calculation here we are doing into an integer. So while waiting, the percent method will be going to throw a number format exception. Go on. It is not processing the request. Will take a look. See now how we are receiving the response. Yes, go ahead.
Actually, I'm sorry, I'm not able to really catch everything. But just at a high level, give me, you know, state the bullet points, you know, when you need to create a web service. So I understood is you created same plain simple Java class, and then the Apache CXF utility to create all the to convert that thing into a web service. And after are the things that we check, you know, to running. Could you state that at just a high level points through the all the files, try to, you know, catch, you know, view, but not really able to catch everything. Just at a brief, at a high level, what are the things that we need to do? We need to look for after those classes are generated to run that.
Yeah, go through the yesterday's class.
Okay.
You're definitely able to. What you can do is you can create one web service application, just write in your Eclipse and Apache CXF.
Okay.
Just follow the recorded session, you'll definitely able to understand all class files created.
Okay. There are 4 or 5 bullet points that I need to do, you know, but
yeah.
Okay.
And in today's class also I explained the whatever that we have discussed, I just elaborated them and explained it again one more time. So did you miss the points or not able to understand any of the stuff that I have explained?
I think else, you know, it's just way too fast for me. I'm not able to really just you know catch one thing and really truly sinks in. You know, it's fast. You know, we move on to the next thing. But I can go back and listen to the recording and then try to get that. That's fine.
Okay. Yeah, because what I want to show is I just want to show the interaction between the WSDL and the Java conversion. And looking at the WSDL file, I guess the code is easy to understand.
Okay.
To understand the WSDL file, by this WSDL interaction, it will be much easy to understand how our Java code communicates between these two elements, between these elements.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome. So then let me know. Okay. Is not able to process the request. Was not able to open the file. Oh, got piled up. Taking two parameters, head of system.out.println some value, return value of sum. Just the basic method. Actually, it was not required for us to throw an exception. It should handle the exception that got generated, and it was supposed to return back to the client with a SOAP. Here we are sending the argument 0 and argument 1 and two numbers, but the it as a string and the second one as a number. In each one verify at the top level. String and argument 1 as 35, and here it was played the message add operation call. This is a it has option string str number format exception has occurred. Handling for the exception, so what it will do is a method was not capable of handling the exception. With the exception will be thrown, the exception is going to throw to the caller method. In case of our so except will be going to read that particular error message, and it will be going to create a SOAP fault exception message. Let us copy an XML file. ML that got generated by your container, it will be going to contain, and inside body it contain your actual this time the except there's no proper response and it has generated an error message. So created a SOAP fault, and the fault code is SOAP server. So that means server exception has occurred. Sometimes SOAP colon client, which means client exception has occurred. If your message provider was not capable of handling the exception will be going to handle by your SOAP itself, and will be going to create a SOAP fault message, and will be back to the client. Our client also not handling the exception. So here, and the exception was thrown back to our main method. An exception occurred with respect to the service provider. It will create an object called js.xml.ws.exception. Operations supposed to handle this particular exception. When any error message just occurred, and you were supposed to catch those exceptions and retrieve the actual information about the error. So this is the method that will be going to throw the exception. So I'm just block. So in see that here you can see what is the error message that got raised: javax.xml.w.soap.default.exception. So your exception object fault message, you can do the fault code and fault string. So soap fault exception block, you can just retrieve get fault the document, store it. For the two things, fault code and get the string. So now from our client side, instead of throwing it back to the main method, we have to retrieve the SOAP error message, and we are able to retrieve what is the error code and what error message. From this, based on these two informations, we can fix the error that will be going to generated by our service provider. And code has received as soap colon server or the e colon print stack trace. Now you will block fault is soap colon server and fault is for input string str. Has occurred for input string str, the handler, by using so called class exception. Handle the exception at the server level itself. You can in a try catch block. Exception, handling the exception manually, but to throw, we want message the user object. So for exception object get a soap for it. Fault is a interface, so you don't have any access of creating the objects using an interface by using your factory class. Factory is just like your session factory kind of stuff, and we'll be going to ask your factory create an instance, and are all the create methods. Either you can create an element or you create your for object. So once after getting the fault object, you can just add the error messages or error code. Fault set. Errors, exception, numat, exception occurred for get placed message. This is our actual exception message. So, and with a soap fault, soap exception. This is also throwing one more exception. At the server level, just because server contains old code, execute our client. Fault code that was named as soap colon SE500, which was set in our server side, and our format exception occurred, localized message for meter that it was specified. And number format exception will be going to associate with our actual error message, and we'll be going to respond it back to the user. Error message, the client to understand that there's an issue with input parameter. On the default exception. So but is so for is an interface, and we don't have any class objects that are related to the soap. So that asking factory to provide one for You can set the fault code and fault string, but find is supposed to respond with so only. So the accepts a parameter, so fault, I'm going to set that one and respond back to the client. On the client, you will be going to receive anyway the SOAP fault exception because you are throwing the server side. SOAP fault exception. To receive the SOAP fault exception, and you're going to contain the fault message, we're going to contain those two strings, the code, the fault value. These errors will be going to handle by using envelope.
Look at the way you call the web service. So you instantiated the service using that paddle URL service name.
Yeah. Instead of going through this particular Java code, it will be if you can understand the WSDL first. So WSDL.
Okay.
If you remember yesterday, we have mentioned that service is just like our Java class. From the Java class level, and this is your service, which is port. So it's just like a method inside service. Ask the port, hey, get me one port. So time, what port will do is it will make a communication to the server by using this particular URL and to associate connection to the server, and it's going to provide you a connection information.
Okay.
We establish the communication to the port. Port has the communication with your port. Was read to or to the element.
Okay.
It's nothing but which will contain operations.
And
so once this one is this one, and you related to binding, your binding was read to. Go to the port type. You were to this particular port type.
Type, what exactly is that? Is that like the type of the object or type of the
No, your port type contains all the operations.
You saw the operations inside the that and all that thing, right? Inside SOAP bind.
This one, here it won't specify about the default operation. It will just specify name of the operation. It is specify about the transport details. The SOAP protocol or HTTP, SMTP or those kind of stuff it will be going to contain. Yes, the operation details as well. But that doesn't serve any purpose because it just contains only the name of the operations. See, each and everything will be separated. Go to image file. Definite purpose. The purpose is only for transport protocol, and it will be going to refer to your port type element. Elements like what is the operation? Name of the operation, right? In our Java level, it will need to take a look at the port type by calculation service. It will go to ops calculation service, and the add operation will be able to contain an input and the output. I'm sorry.
Yeah. Then this WSDL operation, this name in the section that you are in right now, it is like saying that these are the methods kind of that are available in the web service, but the thing is actually the actual definition for that method, what are the input parameters and everything. And
if you're going to specify that your operation consists of an input and output, but specifying what is the data type or what is the actual message that it is referring. Here, if you take a look at here, operation name, same same as that here, but we'll be going to specify what exactly that this input will be going to contain.
Message TNS add again is what is that?
If you were, if you think you were your operation,
okay.
Add method is your operation. And is nothing but your input parameter. This will be going to point to the message, which is the output return. Input going to contain a output. Inter and output is nothing but your return value.
Oh, but all the web service calls have to return something. Yes. Okay, it makes sense.
We have one. We'll be going to discuss that one.
Okay. Okay.
Now go back to the TNS add.
Okay.
Parameters. The add message consists of the parameters, which is going to refer element as DNS colon add. Go to your add. If you take a look at the complex type, it consists of two arguments, argument 0 and argument 1, which are but your input parameters.
Okay.
And then it will be easy for you to one by one.
So this schema file then for
your WSDL is also nothing but a XML file, right?
Right. This is okay. And it is.
I'm sorry.
Yeah. Will all these TNS things elements be defined in that XSD then?
We have specified it as two different separate XSD. You have the option of specifying them inside this element directly instead of you specifying it as a separate XSD. Whatever that you have specified as a separate XSD element, you can see them and place the type. You all the data type. Option like either you can specify it here, or if you think like this is a clumsy, if you are defining all the elements here, then you can go for a separate XSD file and you declare the elements there.
Okay, I'm just trying to get this hierarchy.
Oh yeah, no issues. No.
Taking but to
yeah no yeah. What you do is what you can do is you can just practice at least one example. Small file and put into a web service and take a look at the WSDL file and then look at the class files, the four important class files that got generated for the client, then you will understand easily. Unless you create on your own, then it will be like you will be able to understand, but you will definitely forget it by tomorrow.
So do we need to actually create the XSD file also, or does it get generated automatically?
The current created automatically.
Okay.
In the web service, let me show it to you. Create this. Click. Generate separate XSD for the time.
Okay.
It will be going to create a separate XSD file. If we specify the checkbox, then it will be to append or embed all those files in the same STL file.
Okay. Makes sense.
Yeah.
Okay.
You're welcome. To the Java files that got generated, so it's not all required for you to go what kind of classes that the how the port and type are got generated and how is going on. So if you go for a real world project, there they won't ask you to write from the scratch. So that's any purpose.
Yeah. My question is, you know, when you go back there, are you working with two separate projects to go back into your Eclipse? You know, the cells are created in one separate project.
I think in first thing is you are doing a service and Tomcat server. And as we are the clients, we are the only ones triggering to our service available at our local host. That's created a second project, which is our client project.
Jobs calculation strings client in the first web service project. Then, that's either don't know if it is strings operations or it is just operations. Service client, right?
For our purpose, it's not for us.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So this quickly has only the web service code, this project, this string operations.
Yeah, it's not required for you to have this one. You can just delete it.
Okay.
Yeah. Think in a server way, like let us say you have developed this particular service, you want to test your service, right, before
right.
publishing to the clients. So it means you'll be going to write a client application as well.
Correct.
That's the reason your CXF has provided that class.
Okay. You don't even need the ops calculation.java too, right? Because you need only the ops calculation service. Correct.
Service is your business interface, SCI. You provide a definition for the method, right?
Okay. Another one is the okay.
Expose your service over by using interface, which is a standard.
Okay, makes sense.
Okay.
Perfect.
Thank you. Yeah. You just practice one web service, then you'll definitely able to understand all the elements.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome. Okay. There are doubts. Which can be used to generate the SOAP request and request to our server. That one is SOAP UI tool. option of 14 days trial version. Download that one and try for 14 days. Just play. Once after you have downloaded the zip file and extracted to some folder, which can have been, and there is a bat file available, Windows bat file. It will be going to open a GUI window. It's not required for us to write a client code and test the server. See, when you make some changes to your server side code, it's not for you to write a client and each and every time. Just make use of some kind of open source tools and import. You can import file. The fundamental requirement for any kind of clients for any only the WSTL file. Even your SOAP UI tool also needs the WSTL. Once you have open, go and create a new project. It's going to ask you some names and ask you some input. Here, initial WSTL. So go WSTL for string Java. Here. Web content WSTL. Okay. It will be going to create one project. So the tool level is project. There is one project icon pick pro service for that one. And once after that, it will be going to create one project and use the SOAP binding. It has create operation add. Let's open that one. So and in my project you can see that the first over which your WSTL location kind of stuff. See, this UI is used for testing kind of stuff. So you go for load test, go for normal test cases, you can write a test case and you say whether you want to perform the load kind of stuff. Let us say you want to handle 10 threads at the same time. So before, just need to verify from your side whether you were capable of handling 10 threads at a time or not, or you were just able to allocate that much memory or not. So the during our testing phase, security kind of stuff information available. Next, go to contain the hierarchy in the same way. You can see that it's same way. And to contain your binding, will be going to specify the details about your service endpoint. If you want, also, what current DC is fine. See, this how it was able to retrieve. It has been the service element. It will be going to read the address location tab, address attribute, and it will be going to populate at this level. you can make a changes to here. Your operation name. First. The Eclipse, the SOAP UI tool has the operation, and in that there the which is referring to messages add is PNS add element and so of two arguments with argument and argument one. So create the SOAP envelope. The top is SOAP envelope. If it needs, we're going to contain a header, optional header, and it will be going to contain a body, and inside we're going to contain the request message. Now normally your client will be going to communicate to the server. Java clients will be going to see only the elements, only for argument one, but the prepared your SOAP will need to wrap up the request method and will be going to submit to the server. But your SOAP UI tool has seen that complex add consists of these two elements. Do operations also, you can see two are optional elements. Then 120. One the execute button. Once you have executed this button, it will be this particular URL which was specified at the top layer. If you the response will be going to display it here. You can see that there are several log files available. SOAP log, hlog, jetty log, error log, w memory log. To provide you what most of that you are doing, you see that each and everything, importing endpoint, importing operation, add, find quarter. So it will show all the clips that you have done. It will be going to log that particular message. So here, get this log message. Can any what kind of message it is following? Yeah, correct. Here you can see that conf4j. To use the log4j technology, and on that side here you can see that it is printing the date, the log level, and the log message. So it uses log4j mechanism. Your HTTP log will be going to contain. Let me execute once. Everything is fine. Your log will be going to contain. You are communicating with respect to web. We use over HTTP communication, use SOAP protocol. So communication, it was supposed to specify some kind of headers, the post operation, and the string of slash services slash ops calculation port and edge 1.1 version. Sorry, the XML content is 334 and the host colon 8080 page. Okay, which is nothing but the success response from the server. The response message. This is the content. Your SOAP UI log, it consists of some small information function related to your request, sending request, receive response, cannot be kept alive indefinitely, got closed. So connection, it has open connection to the IP server that you have provided, and finally it has closed the connection. We're going to specify it here. You can also how much memory it is consuming with request. Request and pass some string. HTTP lock. The state for the request, but the response has received as 500 internal server error. HTTP.15 internal server error. Those are nothing but errors. And fault response from our server or number format exception has occurred. Are useful when you want to test, when you want reading the Java code. So going well and writing each and every time when you have made some changes to your code, when we test or when we want to do the test kind of stuff. So there is one other tool which is JMeter. You can just go for the one as well and try testing. That's the purpose. SOAP UI tool you can use for testing. Security kind of stuff. You're correct. The connection shutdown. Previous closed. Why the connection got shut down here? Because the server has specified it is not able to process, and this is an error with respect to the server. Now, instead of sending only one request, we'll send. And we'll test just add test our current request only, select operation to invoke, which means we select existing request. Was success or not? Test case requested or triggery normal request, and use test case and adding the test step. Define, and once executing, it will be going to show in color or green color whether the process. Side green color. Right click so it will be going to provide you seven options. Like performing the load test means we want to verify like threads you want to hit for a second specified here. Like you want to go for the normal strategy, like thread strategy means it will be going to use how many number of threads you want to start and how many number of threads I want to increase. If you want to go for normal thread strategy, normal strategy, then you can see what are number of transactions that's going to hit per second, which is nothing but your TPS. yes, and how number of bytes will be going to transfer to the server and going to triggered within the minimum and maximum and at an average. So that means it is requesting at a time or it is waiting. For so user or your lead will be going to ask you how much load that your service will be going to handle within a second. Load it can handle within, so those kind of information that will be going to be used by you for your JVM is handling. Of bytes got increased. JVM is getting full here. You can see that it is going up and down. 50 requests for 1 second. So current allocated memory, it's not at all possible to hit 50 requests. So what we'll take a look at the statistics and then going to increase the memory size, or they'll be going to allocate required hardware resources used. See your unit testing, because once you have developed the service, you need to provide the results to your manager or lead specifying that your test was successful and able to verify to send to the normal testing phase. That you can do, or normally the load test will be going to perform by your QA leads or QA team. The SOAP UI tool. After writing a small service, make use of that, and the WSTL file here, place, and then create a normal request first. And after all the options that are available, new don't test case, launch test runner, and after that, create a load test. Some request to the load test, start the load test, and verify how much memory that it will be going to use. So, or sometimes the not proper. File. This is actual WSTL file from my telecom project. Lot of it won't be like a single element here. That it will be going to contain the address and one of that the formation with the probe operation or complete research. And you consist of an input message, probe operation, and probe operation response. And is referring to iconfig request, and these above elements are related to your request. Related to your request. Let me generate a small XML. So all that are required, once you have sent events on the server side, you will be write the code in such a way that if at all, if there is any required element which was available in the request XML, you will be able to throw a so-called exception to the client. Server side, they will be going to write validation for each and every element. Each element. Order type, implementer type, and that the data info consists of attributes, number of ports, exchange, and again consists of different elements, vendor, make, model, type, config, user. It consists of one more complex element, port info, and one more element, TN info, which control elements consists of again several elements. So XML will be the WSTL will be going to specify, and the actual communication between client and server will be going to happen. Namespace. Let me know if you guys have any questions. I'll be going to show you one more example.
I think this is Sushya.
Yeah.
So if I the primitive data types here, right, in the inputs and output, but if you are passing the
oh yeah,
such as employee or whatnot, they will the correct or is it change,
but your data types, see currently I have shown one example with respect to iconfig pro operation.
Yeah,
this one it consists of exactly the complex elements.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. Today's class. If you have any questions, you can ask me, or else we'll start DJP tomorrow. Yeah. Yeah.
Can we download?
Possible for download from now onwards, because it will be going to store on the server only.
Uh-huh.
It's not possible for me to store at my local disk level.
For some time or?
Yeah, it will be available at least for 30 days. But also if you can ask if the file is not available, you can just send an email to the coordinators and they'll be going to upload that for you.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
If you could get that file, just upload it to the same place that you've been, because it's been working out.
Yeah.
And this in the last couple of weeks of the class now, you know, we are changing this thing.
See, actually, this is how I asked those guys from the first onwards.
Right.
So you're not supposed to export the recorded file to outside. We can access to the recorded file, but not as a local disk storage.
And that, you know, all the things that you've been saying, not to hear some of that. That's the reason. There were friends who were asking too, but I didn't really share anything so far. So
yeah.